Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna share an interview experience of Jaspi of one of the candidates who has placed in Jaspi as a SDE role and one of the candidates who has placed in Jaspi as a SRE role. I'm going to tell a difference between SDE role and SRE role in a Jaspi, and also I'm going to tell about a selection process of both the roles. Like what are the preparation you have to do for SRE role and what are the preparation you have to do for SDE role. So yeah, this particular video is going to be based on Jaspi interview experience with a question. I'm going to tell you an important question of Jaspi interview. Important question asked in a Jaspi coding rounds. So that you can get idea about like what are the types of questions asked in a Jaspi and what the label of the questions asked in Jaspi. And before starting the other stuff, I will tell you that this video is going to be life-changing video for you if you are aiming to get into Jaspi through one of the role, because if you watch this video, you will get all the knowledge, all the idea about the selection process. So yeah, let's start the video without any further ado. So I have listed three processes. These are not rounds, these are processes. So let's talk about each and every process. The first process is online rounds. The online round contains MCQ test, coding A test, coding B test. I will talk about each and every rounds in detail. Before talking that, let's see what are the selection processes. The second process is hackathon. This hackathon may be hackathon or learnathon, based on requirements and needs. And the last process is interviews. Interviews contains one or two technical interview followed by HR interview. So let's deep dive into each and every selection process. So the first process is online rounds. Online rounds are vary based on off campus and based on campus. Let's talk about off campus first. There are multiple platforms through which Jaspi hires, but most of the time Jaspi hired through a Unstop platform and a Hacker Earth platform. The hiring process of both the platforms are quite different. Through Unstop, they first take 30 MCQ based test, which is totally based on your core subject like DBMS, computer networks, data structures and algorithm operating system. They ask the theoretical question and also a pseudocode kind of question from data structures and algorithm in these process. And the time duration for these process is only 30 minutes. And for every question, you will get only 1 minute. So you have to solve these question in certain time durations. So for the Unstop, they take 30 MCQ first and then they proceed. And for the on campus and the Hacker Earth, they start from 3 coding questions. These 3 coding questions are totally based on tree and graph. If you have good knowledge of tree and graph, you will able to solve that. And if you don't have a good knowledge of tree and graph, can you able to solve that? Yeah, of course you can able to solve that. There are some hacks through which you can solve this question. I will tell you the hacks. What you can do is, you can go through all the Jaspi previous year questions. For this, you can go through all the Jaspi previous year questions. And many of the times, they give that repeated questions. And if they change that question, you can see a pattern between that question and the previous year question. So if you are able to solve that previous year question, then you are definitely able to solve these 3 coding questions. The time duration for 3 coding question is 1.5 hours. And many of the times you have to solve all 3 coding questions so that you can go into the next rounds. Let's talk about the next round, which is 1 coding question. The name of this round is Hackathon. I have not mentioned in Hackathon section this because I will talk something different in Hackathon, but the name of this round is Hackathon. Many of the time, they ask question tree of a space, a very famous question based on tree. And they give 3 hour time for solving these particular question. The only question, the name of this round is hackathon. The name of this question is tree of a space. And many of the times they ask tree of a space, tree of a space, tree of a space. You can go through the problem statement of tree of space in the internet, but you don't find any solution of that tree of space because the tree of space question is very much lengthy. You have to understand and you have to solve the tree of space. The tree of space itself contains many internal steps, many internal questions. If you are able to solve this question in this particular round, you don't have to go through the hackathon round or the learnathon round. If you are able to solve that particular question, which is tree of space or other question similar to tree of space, you don't have to go through it. You don't have to go through hackathon or learnathon part. You directly jump into the interviews. So let's talk about hackathon. Hackathon or learnathon are a 1 or 2 day development program. What the development program means, they give you a certain problem statement along with reference materials so that you can solve that problem statement and showcase themselves. And for showcasing that, they will join you on a Slack channel. They will allocate one of the people to you and you will communicate to that people throughout your development process. What are the hacks to crack this development process? What you can do is, let's suppose you have given to develop a certain kind of software. They are likely based on Docker, Kubernetes, Prometheus and Grafana. You have to be good in these technicals. They all are parts of DevOps. Docker, Kubernetes, Prometheus and Grafana, they all are part of DevOps. So what you can do is, in that problem statement, there are many steps, 4 or 5 steps. After solving each and every step, you have to talk with your, let's say, peer they have allocated to you, and you have to tell that I have completed this step, so that they can get to know that you are interested in this development process. Apart from this, if you are facing any issue throughout this step, you can talk to your allocated people. They will surely help you out through audio communication or through video communication. All right, but you don't expect every time they are helping you. You have to, sometimes you have to solve that problem by your own. Everyday check interviews are going to happen. Suppose that there are 2 day development program. On the first day, you have solved 3 steps. So based on 3 steps, they're going to schedule an interview on that day, on the end of that day, and they will ask a question related to these 3 steps. You have to answer the questions. And based on your answer, they will give a certain mark, certain points to you. So that based on that point, you will get into next steps. So yeah, hackathon is over. Let's go through interviews. The first one is technical interview one. Those candidates who have cleared coding round B, that is a 3 hour coding, they are directly jump into this round. This technical interview for those candidates are going to last for 1 day, and throughout the day, they are going to ask different types of question based on tree, graph, linked list and all, based on data structures and all. They are mainly checks your data structures and algorithm part, because this is for SDE role. And apart from these, many of the questions are going to related to tree of space. They are going to break tree of space question or any other question related to tree of space. They are going to break that question in multiple parts, and they will going to ask a question based on that multiple parts. They will going to tell you that you have to solve these part through different approach, and you have to solve that so that they can get to know about how good are you in tree or a graph type of topics? So that question, they will get to know about that. And of course, they will start from introduction. They will ask some questions on your project. They will ask some questions on computer networks. So you have to be good in computer network also. So yeah, these round, especially for SDE role, and those candidate who have cleared this round, they don't have to go through technical round 2. They are directly jumped into HR round. So let's talk about technical round 2. Technical round 2 are for those candidate who have cleared hackathon. And in this round, they will start from, of course, your introduction, of course, your project. And then they will going to ask question based on, particularly based on, what are the things you have done in hackathon. Let's suppose the things you have done in hackathon are based on Docker, Kubernetes, Prometheus and Grafana. They will ask many questions based on Docker, what is Docker, how we can create Docker images, what are the benefits of Kubernetes, how you can apply Prometheus and Grafana stuffs in Docker and Kubernetes. These type of questions they will ask. They will also ask certain commands in Docker, Kubernetes and all. And you have to tell the commands, of course. Apart from this, they will also ask questions based on computer networks. So you have to be good in computer networks also. So yeah, technical round 1 is over, technical round 2 is over. Technical round is for SD, technical round 2 is for SRE. Alright, so let's go into final round, which is HR round. Of course, in HR round, they will going to start from your introduction, then they will ask some question based on your project, then they will ask some question on your previous interviews, like the experience of previous interviews and some question related to previous interviews. And finally, they will ask a question based on your hobbies. They will basically check your hobby in this part. Apart from studies, what are the things you are doing in your daily life? That's a really matter in HR round. So they will focus on your hobby part so that they can check your other stuffs, and especially communication stuff, because communication is also one of the key role to be placed in JustPay. If you clear HR round for SD role, you will get 27 LPA package, and if you clear HR round for SRE role, you will get 11 LPA package. So yeah, that's all for this video, guys. If this video is really important for you, please like and share this video, and also subscribe to my channel if you are new to my channel. And of course, if you have any question, you can ask that question in the comment section. I will definitely give the answers of that question in the comment. So yeah, that's all. We will meet next time.